So my grandmother, see, and the reason, and I mostly care about, like, the registering of religious people, because I am a Christian. Don't applaud. Nobody ever does. It's fine, because everyone who says they're a Christian usually says, I never tell anyone, because the next words out of somebody's mouth is always something horrifying. So I never do tell anyone. I just try to be, because I was raised in a very nice church where it was essentially be like the nice man in the picture and go get your dad some coffee. That was the whole plan. That was the whole religion in a nutshell. It was please pick up the dishes and try to be nice. So I'm Armenian, which here's the thing. It's in Wisconsin, I have to explain that it's not a Baltic swordfish. It's a country in the middle of nowhere. And the Armenian Christians were killed in a genocide in 1915. The Turks deny it. They've taught their children and their grandchildren it never happened. Here's what I have to say. If you're holding a genocide, by the way, don't take pictures. You're not smart. That's not smart. Too many photos. We see what you're doing. Okay, so... But here's what, my grandmother lived through it. They were marched through Syria, everybody died, she didn't die. So my grandmother talked about the genocide 3 times when I was a kid. And because I asked her about it, 2 times, funny stories, hilarious genocide stories. A lot of people don't know. People who live through a genocide, they're funny. So my grandmother told me, she said that when the Turks came to take them out of their tiny village, first of all, there was bread in the oven. She was 60 years later, still worried about it. I think it burned. But the Turkish general in charge of their village let her family bring their family donkey so that my grandmother's grandmother could ride it. And my grandmother's grandmother was going to ride this donkey, but the village priest of the Armenian church stole the donkey so that he could ride the donkey. And my grandmother, at 16, picked up a 2x4 and beat the priest off of the donkey. Yeah. Yeah. And she told me that story when I told her that I didn't want to go to church anymore. And she said, I go to church, you'll go to church. And so... I was 13 and I was doing genealogy, right? I made her cry. So I made her, because I was doing genealogy, I asked where all of her siblings were. And she was like, well, they all died. And then I pressed her. I was like, how did they die? And she's like, stop talking to me. And she cried and I made her cry and I felt very sad. And then since I was 13, I was just like, well, what was it like? What was it like, the genocide? And she said, well, for every 200 Armenians, there was one Turkish soldier who was in charge of that part of the line. And then she just stared at me, essentially daring me to ask. And I did. And I said, why didn't you guys just tackle him? There were so many more of you, could have killed him and just tackled him. And she said, none of us wanted to be the first to die, so we all died. And the reason she told me that, because she wants me to be the first to die. I'm just going to fucking tackle him, you guys. Nobody gets on the trains. Nobody. No. Anyway, so I saved the second funny story for last, because why not? Order of, I don't know how to do comedy. I do. The rule of three! The rule of three! Finish the fucking story. Here it is. So, she said as they were walked by these villages in Syria, the villagers would come out because they didn't have television, and they would ask the women in line what their names were, and if you told them, they would go to the soldier in charge of that part of the line and buy you, and then you had to go with that dude. And my grandmother said that whenever the guys would ask her name, she would throw rocks at them. And she told me that story when I told her I had a crush on a guy when I was 15, and it wasn't going well. And she said, yeah, we're not good with men, Jackie. So...